Welcome to Seed to Life. I hope you are doing well and keeping safe. We all care about our beloved earth and want it to live forever for our future generations. Once you start gardening, you automatically start caring more about your environment because you want the purest possible food for yourself and your family. And that is the reason I'm starting this new series, Repurpose and Recycle. Today, I'm going to share with you a simple project to repurpose the empty juice bottles by making them planters. So let's begin. I had a packet of old swim diapers that my son did not use when he was a baby, and I wanted to donate them, but the packet was already open and later it passed the expiry date. I had seen in one of those DIY videos that you can use the gel from the diapers to make potting mix more water retaining, and I was very much impressed with that video. So I had kept it for that reason, but I never used it actually because I didn't know if it is safe to use it for edible plants. Then I also keep these empty juice bottles that I use in my garden in various ways. I avoid buying the smaller juice packets because that way we can avoid using soft plastic that is harder to recycle. So I decided to use them for planters. To have enough access to put the soil inside, I cut the top 1/4 of these bottles with my rotary blade. If you don't have it, you can use a hot knife or blade, or you can use a handsaw, taking proper precautions of course. I didn't remove the top completely. Instead, I cut the bottle from three sides, leaving the fourth side intact, and that way the bottle looked like a box with a hinge that opens and closes. The next step is to make some drainage holes. So for that you can take some sharp instrument and heat it up on the flame, and then you can use that to make holes at the bottom of these plastic bottles. Our bottles are ready now, and you must be wondering why I didn't take out the top completely. No, I was not being lazy. There is a reason for that. As I have mentioned it nearly 100 times in my previous videos, the weather in my region is very unpredictable. This partially open lid, it creates a greenhouse-like effect by retaining moisture longer. It also protects the new plants by preventing overwatering in heavy rain. They allow good circulation also. So for baby plants, this works like a personalized greenhouse, and I love it. Now I'm going to add a piece of a diaper at the bottom of this planter. You can use conventional soil mixed with layer of gravel or mulch at the bottom, but if you use such bottles for small seedlings, then there is a high chance of uneven watering or overwatering in such tall planters. Eventually, algae start developing in the soil, and even though they do not directly harm the plants, the moist environment can attract fungus gnats and also can cause root rot. I always have this problem with such tall planters. On the other hand, if the planter is not tall, as the concrete underneath heats up, it just burns the delicate roots. When I added this diaper piece, I believe it absorbed the excess moisture whenever there was overwatering and acted as the source of water when the soil was dry. So it balanced the moisture content in the potting mix perfectly. I used it for flowering plants, so I didn't have to worry about chemicals. I had three other seedlings of the same plant, and only one of them I planted in such tall bottle, and this is the only one that survived in this hot summer. So I'm going to use the same trick while planting new seedlings. That way I don't even have to change the soil very often. After that, I carefully planted seedlings into the new planter and all set. Because the roots could grow deeper, they were more protected and the plant grew well in the pot even in summer. I hope you like this video. A big thanks to you for watching my videos and supporting my channel Seed to Life. Please click subscribe for more such videos and updates. Click the bell icon to get notified about future videos. And feel free to reach out to me through comments, Facebook, Twitter or Instagram if you have any questions. I am posting the links in the description. I would love to hear your suggestions and would like to know the news of your garden. Happy gardening. Thank you again. See you soon.